I greet my views, actually. As a progressive and political commentator at a liberal blog. Actually, I want to, you know, to cover, domestic American politics, you know, politics, and then want to pay attention to inhumanity, indignity of politics of Republican President Trump. Well, first he ordered to detain and then incarcerate political asylum seekers and border crossers from Central America. You know, he's a racist, you know very well, with a count of people, mostly Latinos, and come from Mexico, Honduras, Guatemala, and our Central American countries, escaping gang violence mostly. But some of them may actually know information and might have some intelligence about narco cartels and stuff like that. Because not all of them, but some of them. And then may be able to exchange it in return for temporary asylum. If I were a asylum officer, you know, in that U.S. Department of Homeland Security, I would be able to issue temporary asylum to those asylum seekers who are capable of providing intelligence about narco cartels, you know, and their members, and whoever, you know, services world narco cartels, like pilots, manufacturers, or chemists, you know, well, actually, so we'll be able to, or the money laundering, so, well, actually, it's worth getting some information and change the return for, in a second. If President Trump were not a mean-spirited, heartless, fascist, Republican right-wing extremist, he would have allowed families, you know, to go free and with only electronic monitoring bracelet on them, you know. And then that would be enough, you know, because it was not a penal offender, you know, to put them, you know, behind the slum, you know, and then lock him up, you know. But President Trump is a sadist, you know. He wants to deport all those illegal border crossers without any ceremonies, without allowing them to get a shot at political asylum, of temporary asylum. And then quite possible, but actually President Trump doesn't want all of it. He wants actually to incarcerate children and adults, even though the only crime they did is crossing the border. Well, it's illegal, actually, of course, it's a federal offense to illegally cross the border and then be in a country without proper visas, of course. I know, but I'm natural US citizen. And then know that was actually border crossings are illegal, of course. But then, still, we should be allowed to walk with freedom, but only with electronic bracelet for monitoring. That's all. It would take, to keep them free, you know, and their families intact, you know, and we would be no problem. But if President Trump doesn't want to ask anybody but his own bright brain, you know, maybe he's not in his own right mind, this stable genius, quote unquote. Okay. Oversight. Because actually, his dumb is stupid enough, you know. He can't deal with asylum seekers without causing a humanitarian crisis, you know, human rights crisis. And then in the second, I must say that happily, a federal judge, one of the federal judges in California, I believe, ordered reunification of all families, ordered the Trump administration to reunite children with adults, with their parents, yes. And then, so it might be some chance, you know, to undo the evil the Trump administration did towards political asylum seekers. And then, actually, what we now talk about that Democrats wants to cancel ICE or immigration police, I believe that majority of Democrats will never do that. I believe that we all need ICE as immigration police that will be able to deport criminal aliens and foreigners who overstayed their visas. Well, you're not eligible for full stay in the United States. And then, in a second, once, recently, there was some kind of challenges with coming from MSNBC. Ali Velchi and his partner were asking a stupid question about why Democrats don't want to cooperate with Koch brothers, who were major donors for Republican Party. It's because just of that. The Koch brothers, give donations only to Republicans as they oppose regulations. Regulations are mainstay of democratic movement, you know. And then we say we Democrats oppose second, we don't. But simply Republicans don't understand. The second man doesn't know when the second man says, but gun control is unconstitutional. It is not. In no possible way, in no possible interpretation, legal interpretation of the Second Amendment. Where it says that American people cannot control, cannot introduce gun control. And I believe that assault weapons and all military weapons should be banned, that magazine capacity should be limited to 10 rounds, per magazine, and then that all those semi-automatic fire seals should be banned as well, and so along with assault weapons, and then also illegal was illegal was templates, you know, and you know, blueprint for printing. A 3D gun, plastic gun, should be banned too, because why the only people who are going to use them are terrorists. Terrorists use them in order to, you know, put it somewhere on the back where nobody will actually tap them, you know, freeze them, and then bring it through the metal container, metal detector, from a metal detector, yes. So no metal detector can then actually discover plastic material. Making a gun out of plastic is rather dangerous because it can blow up in the hands of its users, first of all. In the second, the only possible users would be terrorists who bring a gun to a federal or courtroom from a metal detector, or bring a gun to a plane again. So that a plastic gun is undetectable to metal containers. That's why terrorists can use it. It's very simple to understand. And then, very simple to understand, we should, such should actually impose gun control by banning all those blueprints for printing 3D plastic guns as devices that promote and facilitate terrorism. It's nothing else to say, because what kind of device? He designed plastic gun. He designed to beat metal detector. That's what it is for. Because so you can bring it unnoticed into a courtroom, into a government building, And it can pass all the metal detectors, pass unnoticed, brought by assassin or terrorist, you know, to kill a government official or blow up or take hostages in a Airbus, you know. And then, yes, and then actually, yeah, that's necessary. Well, first of all, we need gun control. We need raise taxes on those wealthy individuals like Koch brothers themselves, those millionaires actors and millionaires sportsmen. Yeah, we should share with people who made them rich, first of all. And anyway, and then what else do we have? Environmental protection. Democrats need regulations, support regulations that enforce environmental protection, first and foremost. Otherwise, our climate will be ruined and will be ravaged by hurricanes and tornadoes, like in Texas. Where the example with the Republican-owned government, you know, Delta Wave, you know, with environmental protection. And then what's happened is now it's so many twists, you know, wrecked lots of Texan lots of Texan towns and you know, hamlets and stuff like that. And then what else do we need? We Democrats stand for social justice. First of all, we would raise workers' minimum wage to at least $13 an hour. Like actually, we do it in California, in Los Angeles. Well, Los Angeles City Council raised minimum wage, we see up to $13.25. I actually did not get hold of that kind of wage. My wage is $12 an hour. You know, so you can see I'm a low-income worker. But then even low-income worker can become a U.S. House representative. And in that quality, I would be able to introduce a ban. Excuse me, a constitutional amendment, to abolish the Electoral College and make history. And then actually, then popular vote is just the only vote that decides the result of the election, the fair deal. Otherwise, what happened now? The majority of Electoral College voters, they oppose the will of a majority of the state voters and vote against. So the will of a majority of American voters, majority, is being dumped by Electoral College minority of electors who actually were corrupted through a system of very high wages, or political appointments, or government jobs, you know, that brought them to the top of money making, like making $200,000 a year, that makes them practically rich people. And they would, that kind of influence is corrupt. And then I would also introduce, as a liberal Democrat, I want to do this 2 weeks paid vacation for all American workers. Mostly for at least for low-income workers. It's a big deal because American workers and California workers, we don't have 2 weeks paid vacation. We don't have a day of paid vacation. And then I want to make healthcare system, you know, to healthcare system affordable for all Americans, especially poor Americans, because poor people have right to life too. We don't have today. I believe that. And I hope that, as a liberal Democrat, you know, I also want to introduce a constitutional amendment to allow naturalized U.S. citizens from relatives of immigrants, legal immigrants, to become U.S. president. First of all, because banning them to become U.S. president is is a nationalistic kind of atrophy from the past. You know, it's kind of anti-democratic institution. In the same electoral college, it's anti-democratic institution, but actually, you know, violates popular vote. Twice, Republicans managed to steal the presidency. Starting with George W. Bush, who actually even lost electoral college. Not only he lost popular votes, he lost electoral college in year 2000. And but the coup d'etat delivered by U.S. Supreme Court conservative majority, well, actually, unfortunately stopped recounting manual ballot recounts ordered by Florida Supreme Court in Palm Beach County in year 2000, November 2000. Now, very historical fact, and I hope that my viewers will never forget it, never always remember that, always remember that what happened in year 2000, when it manual ballot recount was stopped by the coup d'etat delivered by U.S. Supreme Court's conservative majority. I decided to take sides, you know, and violate democracy. I want to say that even in America, even poor workers, low-income workers, can become a U.S. House representative, even members of assembly, in spite of our even poor health and shortcomings of my personality, I can deliver lots of positive good to my fellow workers. You know, we need 2 weeks paid vacation. We need a time and a half period for hours worked overtime. And then what we need is 1 month paid vacation for pregnant women, at least. Yeah. And, well, yeah, in Los Angeles County, for instance, we have lots of housing being built, affordable housing being built, and I see it in the city of Los Angeles, you know, well, apartment buildings, actually small apartments, but built for poor workers, you know, or homeless people. And actually, because in Los Angeles City, the rent of average one-bedroom apartment costs like $1,600 a month, which is extremely high. And then in the city of Burbank, monthly rent of one-bedroom apartment costs $2,000. And actually, I believe that Burbank residents simply want to get rid of all the rent. Because very frankly, nobody was going to rent in the city of Burbank, not from the ranks of low income, even middle class people. Will be very much burdened by this hefty burden of $2,000 per one, you know, small one bedroom apartment per month, you know. That's too much. Now I believe also that but actually what else? What else? I want to say that that Elie Welch at MSNBC decided to probably push forward Cox's stupid ideas about a Democrat being stupid enough, you know, to cooperate with Cox's who are oppose any either Democrats, but based on recognizing government regulations in order to enforce environmental protection, to enforce gun control, to enforce social justice, and those all things what the Democrats mostly support of, because unless of course we're double crosses and you know, playing with Trojan horse. By the way, Koch brothers, that millionaires from gas and oil industry, we want to play probably a Trojan horse for Democrats. But let them tell me something. We Democrats don't need corruption. We Democrats don't need any money from Koch brothers. And we do not sell themselves. And why not? I tell Mr. Welch, we are not prostitutes, political people. We don't sell ourselves for money. We don't change our political view for money. So what Mr. Ali Velshina knows that the way we Democrats operate, we use crowdfunding websites, okay, in order to give donations, you know, for our party. We use town hall, you know, to give donations, you know, from willing donors, you know, as much as we use government limits, you know, of maximum donation we can get about $2,400 from a person in the first place. And then in the second, we're not chasing big-time donors. We don't violate federal donations, you know, laws, federal laws about donations, you know. Federal donations, we know limits. We know we cannot spend them on anything personal. With money, we're going to spend them on political expenses, like buying ads, political ads, or for instance, what else? Doing our political expenses, in our advertising our political views as much as we want. But then, even low income workers can afford even to pay the electoral fee, which about ranges with some of $900 something, using the tax return checks. If let's say if you don't owe any money to the IRS, you can actually get a standardized deduction, tax deduction of $2,400, and then it's good enough to pay an electoral fee. So we're not a desperate position to beg for money. I believe, some of us may be really broke and come from a poor family. And then what can I say? But so if Republicans think we can get run the country without the help of political experts, they are wrong. They simply will be too stupid enough. And having too much political power is not the same thing as have political expertise. Political expertise is necessary. The same military expertise is necessary in order for politicians to make correct decisions. Because at the right time, we won't have a political or military expertise to make the right decisions. And in a second, I want to discuss that Republican President Trump's extremist, right-wing extremist decision to introduce tariffs, you know, and customs duties, an increase of tariffs at the amount of 15% and 25% on all the imports of aluminium and steel from China and Western Europe, for instance, from Russia. This is outrageous, you know. The way President Trump introduced those tariffs that cover $300 billion package of imported goods, you know, this is outrageous, you know. That way, those countries like China will respond with retaliatory tariffs and customs duties, and then increases of those customs duties. And what will make soybean growers, for instance, soybean farm destitute, will lose all their income. And they make at least $50 billion each year for selling their soybeans to the Chinese consumers. And then, you see, so President Trump thinks that he will pay like federal donations, kind of welfare program for farmers. So you see, if you kind of red state farmers, you know, are satisfying, yet receiving federal welfare instead of making profits on soybeans, on their products, it's another matter. I don't know what can I say. But I thought that America might be smart enough not be losers like that, you know, and then depend on federal donations, you know, just to survive instead of making $50 billion only on exports of soybeans to China. And then I believe that also after raising tariffs on aluminium and steel, aluminium steel products, you know, like end product, like let's say aluminium cans, when you drink soft drinks and beer, will become more expensive, right? And then the price will be passed to consumers by manufacturers, by American manufacturers. So what he did, simply raise taxes on American consumers. And then he made sure that American manufacturers will lose most of their exports. And you know, and he said we have a thriving economy. We don't have a thriving economy. This is kind of, we're just in the eye of the storm, you know. It's within the eye of the storm with dead steel. And when the storm comes, you know, nothing will be left intact. You know, we'll be no 4%, 4% unemployment rate. And boy, hopefully. But I think that this actually, this particular politics of corrupt President Trump, reactionary, plain evil, you know. And then I believe that President Trump is corrupt and take bribes, and then he actually sells corrupt influence. And then like he received 500 million donations from Chinese government, being invested into industrial park owned by Trump organization in Indonesia. And then imagine how many millions of dollars went into a pocket of this corrupt Republican buffoon, President Trump, who actually never made no blind no blind trust, you know, of his corporation, Trump Corporation. Simply he simply take bribes and think he can get away with it. That's because Republicans yet control, still control U.S. Congress, U.S. House of Representatives, and U.S. Senate. But then, the majority U.S. House of Representatives and U.S. Senate is slim. It's slim. It doesn't demand a solid majority. It's less than two-thirds. And then with the chance that and indications of that Democrats might prevail during November elections, and then CNN polls put like preference of possible potential voters, like 10%. They have a lead. Democrats have a lead of 10% over Republicans in both CNN polls, and then. You may imagine what's going to happen in November. President Trump thinks that only about getting away with actually violating the Emoluments Clause, with bribery, with obstruction of justice. And then, but I believe that Democrats will take over both chambers of U.S. Congress. And will actually impeach and convict corrupt Republican President Trump. And hey man, actually I am a liberal Democrat. I actually broadcast for only mostly for liberals and independents, and then not for conservatives, you know. And then because we can stay with our own bloggers, with our own right-wing media, with our own Fox News. Or whatever, Hannity's, I don't know, and our talk show hosts, you know, who actually share with the right-wing extremist views. I don't. And then, like I explained, let's say, given what America needs, it's a constitutional amendment to ban the Electoral College, an unconstitutional institution. Which actually denies the will of American majority of voters, which he did twice. this century, 21st century. Is it very important? Very important for all American voters in order to, to regain to democracy, first of all. We regain to democracy if we ban electoral college, first of all. In the second, neither CNN or MSNBC, they don't tell us, Democrats, what to do, what to think, and what political legislation should we adopt, as Democrats are strong-willed politicians, and they adopt those political agenda and those political views and decisions only on their own political will. You should not take them for suck-ups to Koch brothers or any other rich scum who you think I can buy any politician, because not every politician is for sale, not every politician political prostitute. As I tell them, most of the Democrats are not. We don't sell ourselves for with money. We mostly work for benefits of American people, and then we stand for progressive ideals, we stand for liberal ideals, and we want to make America liberal, we want to make America free and progressive as possible. We protect the environment, and we enforce gun control laws, and sure as hell, we're gonna ban and buy out assault weapons like been done in Australia. Well, Australia, for instance, wasn't quite progressive, but they managed to buy out all the assault weapons from gun owners. Yeah. We can do the same thing. The same thing. And then, what I think is, we all have our own shortcomings. One is, I'm low income and my health is not so good. And then, it's our work. If people like me get elected to U.S. House of Representatives or State Assembly, we actually make lots of good for our voters, for fellow workers, you know, like me, who are poor like me, they can't afford pay for 2 weeks vacation, right? And then, also endorse American public to vote for Democrats, so Democrats won, run away, we can win legally, and like our dear California Governor Edmund Brown says, we will raise taxes only when voters approve it. So we can include referendums, you know, you think that voters might not approve of raising taxes. We use the referendum, you know, to determine if it's the right decision or not, but then, yeah. And we won't raise taxes even on corporations without will of majority of our voters expressed at a referendum. Then actually, I believe that actually I would be interested in actually your feedback, and once even I receive feedback from bygones who actually asked me if I want to become your president. No, I didn't. I cannot do that because the law, federal law, precludes national citizens from becoming U.S. president. But I can introduce a constitutional amendment to allow nationalized U.S. citizens to become U.S. president. That will enable, let's say, two times California governor, Republican, moderate Republican, Arnold Schwarzenegger, to become a U.S. president, if he wants, to run for U.S. president. Yeah, make me so much justice, at least for Arnold Schwarzenegger, you know, popular movies. And then, actually, it will make our country, more democratic, and then free, so we could have more freedom. Because we have less freedom, and actually I enjoyed very much at Obamacare, because Obamacare allowed low-income workers to pay only $60 a month for the insurances on individual level, and then government paid federal government paid about $200 as a subsidy. But then, there was a problem with coverage. If you have a dependent, some companies like Molina insurance company, which had $400 a month, as an insurance premium. But that was actually outrageous. Even with Obamacare, at exchanges been insured by federal government. And then, I would say, how would families make it? Because we won't be able to pay $400 a month just for insurance for their children. And they will have to get by probably by ATP, ability to pay programs being run by state government in order to treat their children. Our 8 hours. Then actually, I hope that. As a liberal blogger, I expect more feedback from my views. My phone number is 303-445-1600, and my email address is armenak.nourdjanin64@gmail.com. I hope I receive some feedback. Because before that, I didn't receive any feedback from my views, but then I received dirty calls. Instead, I received dirty calls from some scumbags, and then hopefully that my views did like my liberal blogging, and then again, I stand for social justice. As most of them are for social justice, environmental protection, for gun control, for amnesty, for non-criminal legal violence. Yeah, we can do very well. Because we can provide amnesty and path to one citizenship, like President Obama put it this way, to non-criminal legal aliens who worked in this country at least 10 years without breaking the law. So how would you expect that? Now I believe that with liberal Democrats actually will never get rid of immigration policy such as because we need to deport all criminal aliens and all the foreigners who overstayed their visas. And are not eligible to stay forever on American soil. Well, this was a real smart idea. And then, what I remember, yes, about President Bush administration. Nancy Pelosi, once was actually making comments about George W. Bush presidency. When I said, how it treated immigrants. How it treated immigrants, I'll explain to you. I applied for visa for my fiancé from Armenia, which actually I visited and brought, some proof as airline tickets. I had proof of airline tickets, records of my visitation, my fiancé. Visited her, and then I had pictures, something like that. But then George Bush official, one of them, I don't remember his name, but he somehow wrote me a letter which said that I should be judged by Russian courts or something like that. It sounded real treasonous to me. I don't know, but then Republicans are like that. Some of them are real corrupt, but yeah, well, they corrupt the politicians and Democrats too. I didn't deny that. But then also, in order to get rid of corruption, I also promise that measure like such a measure as term limit to introduce a term limit, we said, where would limit term of politicians to 3 terms, you know, limit political life to 3 terms only, and then what would get rid of corruption and get rid of political marasm and get rid of political dementia as well, and would be highly beneficial for American people.